Hello everyone, this is Dr. Surya. Now we are going to solve a problem on centrifugal pump. So once a problem is given as pump, we have to draw the velocity triangle diagram for the particular pump. So I have drawn already the velocity triangle diagram for a centrifugal pump. So this is the velocity triangle diagram of a centrifugal pump. Then we have to write our given data. So the first thing is that a centrifugal pump is having the outer diameter is equal to 2 times the inner diameter. So which means that my outer diameter I am going to denote it as D2. So outer dia D2 and inner diameter is going to be D1. So which is nothing but my D2 is going to be 2 times the D1. So next given us, it is running at 1200 rpm. So which means that my n value is given. So n is equal to 1200 rpm. So next is that it works against a total head of 32 meter. So my total head is given to me, which is nothing but hm is going to be 32 meter. So the next data is the velocity of flow through the impeller is constant and equal to 3 meter per second. So velocity of flow, generally we denote it as Vf. So the velocity of flow is going to be constant. This is what is given in the problem. So Vf1 is equal to Vf2, which is equal to 3 meter per second. So next is that the vanes are set back at an angle of 30 degree at the outlet. So this is what is given in the problem. So vane angle is outlet is nothing but phi, which is equal to 30 degree. The next data is if the outer diameter of the impeller is 600 mm. So which means that my D2 value is given as 600 mm. So anything which is given in mm or centimeter, first convert it into meter. So 600 mm, if we convert, it becomes 0.6 meter. So once we have calculated our D2, it is very easy to calculate the value of D1 as given in the problem. So which is nothing but D2 is equal to 2 times the D1. So 0.6 is equal to 2 times my D1. So from here I'll be getting my D1 value as 0.3 meter. So my inner diameter becomes 0.3 meter. So next is that the width of the outlet is 50 mm. So generally we denote our width by B. Since because it is given in the problem as outlet, we are going to denote it as B2. So B2 is going to be 50 mm. So 50 mm means we have to convert it into meter, which is 0.05 meter. So now we have written all the given data. Next we have to write what are the things we are going to find out. So the first thing is that determine vane angle at inlet. So which means we have to determine the value of theta. The next one is work done per second by impeller. So we have to get the value of work done. Next is manometric efficiency, which is eta manometric. So these are the three things we have to determine. So first, in order to calculate the value of vane angle at inlet, we have to check our velocity triangle diagram. So from the velocity triangle diagram, we can get the value of theta. So it's very simple that tan theta is equal to Vf1 by U1. So we are going to check that I know the value of Vf1, which is given in the problem as 3 meter per second. I don't know the value of theta as well as I don't know the value of U1. So first I have to calculate the value of U1. So as we all know, the U1 the formula is pi D1 n by 60. So which is equal to pi into, the value for D1 is 0.3 and n is 1200 divided by 60. So from this I'll get the value of my U1 as 18.85 meter per second. So the unit is going to be very important. So U1 is my tangential velocity. Since because it's velocity, we have to use the unit as meter per second. So from here I can easily calculate the value of tan theta. So tan theta is equal to Vf1 value is 3 and U1 value we have determined as 18.85. So from here tan theta is equal to 0.159. So which is theta is equal to tan inverse of 0.159. So from here I'll get my theta value as 9 degree 2 minutes. So I have, first thing, I have got the value of theta, that is vane angle at inlet. So next thing, I have to get the value of work done. So the formula for work done is given as W by G VW to U2, where W denotes the weight of water. Okay, so for W we are going to write the formula as rho gq. So generally we will be writing for weight the formula as rho g, but here we are going to use rho gq because major amount of water is going to play in the pump. So we are including our q value also. Q value is nothing but the volume of water. So how much volume of water is going inside the pump, that is also we are going to take into account. So my formula becomes work done is equal to rho g q by g into vw to u2. Now I have to check whether I know all the values. So I think I know the value of g, I know the value of rho. Other than that, I don't know any other value like q, vw2 and u2. So I have to calculate each and every value first. Now I'll start with u2. So as you all know, u2 value formula for u2 is pi d2 n by 60, so which is equal to pi into 0.6 into 1200 divided by 60. So I'll be getting the value as 37.699 meter per second. Next I have to get the value of q. For centrifugal pump, the formula for q is given as pi into d2 into b2 into vf2. So pi into, I know the value of d2 which is 0.6, b2 is already given in the problem, that is 0.05, and vf2 and vf1 are the same, so which is equal to 3. So I'll be getting my q value as 0.283, and the unit for q is going to be meter cube per second. Next I have to get the value of VW2. So it's not easy to get the value of VW2. So VW2 I should check in the velocity triangle diagram where it comes. So I can see that in the outlet velocity triangle diagram I am having my VW2. But the only known value to me is I know the value of phi and I know the value of U2, I know the value of VF2. So from using the phi and U2 value, I can easily get the value of my VW2. So I can write my tan phi is equal to VF2 by U2 minus VW2. So in simple, I can say that tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So I have used the same formula. So which is my tan phi value is 30 degree is equal to 3 by 37.699 minus VW2. So solving this equation, I'll be getting my VW2 value as 32.503 meter per second. So VW is nothing but my whirl velocity at the outlet. Okay, so I got my value of VW2. Now I can easily get the value of my work done. So as I mentioned earlier, for work done the formula is rho g q by g into VW2 U2. So which is nothing but 1000 into 9.81 into 0.283 into 32.503 into 37.699 divided by 9.81. So I'll get my work done value as 346.493 into 10 power 3 Newton meter per second. Next, I have to get the value of manometric efficiency, which is denoted by Eto manometric. The formula for Eto manometric is GHM by VW2 U2. So I know all these values. So G value is 9.81. Head value is given in the problem as 32. And I have calculated my VW2 value as 32.503. And I have calculated my U2 value as 37.699. So solving this, I'll be getting my Eto manometric at 0.2564. Since because it is efficiency, I have to denote it as person. So which is 25.64%. Enjoy your learning. Thank you.